Conditional statements are statements made in logic. These will be, the reason we're talking about them is because we will be using them in proofs in upcoming chapters. There are two parts to a conditional statement. The hypothesis, which, just like in science, is the maybe. I think. I believe that if I water the plants, they'll grow taller. And let me check it out now. So this is the perhaps. If you're 16, the conclusion would be, then it is legal for you to have a driver's license. So in a conditional statement, the hypothesis is the if portion of the statement. The conclusion is the then portion of the statement. There's a way to represent conditional statements symbolically as well. If P, then Q, where P is the hypothesis, Q is the conclusion. If P, then Q. And the logic symbol for if then is this arrow symbol. Now, there are a whole bunch of statements that go with conditionals. If P, then Q, you see the statement here, if P, then Q. Converse statements reverse it. If Q, then P. A converse statement for if you are 16, then you may have a driver's license is, if you have a driver's license, it's okay for you to have a driver's license, then you're at least 16. An inverse statement involves the negation of these. The inverse, notice it is in the form, in the order again of P first and Q second. However, now we've got the not symbol, so it's not P. If not P, then not Q. That statement looks like, if you are not 16, then you may not have a driver's license. If you are not at least 16, it's not legal for you to have a driver's license. Contrapositive is the nots again, with the Q first. Not if not Q, then not P. If it is not legal for you to have a driver's license, then you are not at least 16 years old. So that's an example of the conditional, the converse, the inverse, and the contrapositive.